I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Bobcats, and happy last Tuesday of the month of February. Here's to hoping that this month was filled with compassion and filled with learning. Today, I bring to you a story about a little girl named Sammy. Sammy created a buddy bench of her own, like we read last week. Sammy created a buddy bench by the help of going to her principal and asking and explaining the idea of a buddy bench. Her school, her friends, her community all came together to collect bottle caps to push together and make a buddy bench at her own school. Let's check out this news story for more information on Sammy and her story. Everyone has a
moment. Now to Everyone Has a Story about a young girl's devotion to making sure everyone has a friend.
Heidi Vance wrote in to tell us about her young daughter, Sammy, who brought the idea of a buddy bench to her community. We'll talk to Heidi and Sammy in just a moment, but first, let's listen to their sweet story.
Toward the end of last summer, my 9-year-old daughter, Sammy, attended a local vacation Bible school where she heard about the idea of the buddy bench. In her words, if someone is lonely, they can go sit on the buddy bench and others know to go up and ask them to play. She's a kind soul and doesn't want anyone to ever feel alone. Sammy came home that evening and told me her school needed a buddy bench, and I suggested that she make an appointment with the principal to ask if they could get one. When she met with the principal and explained her idea, he was excited and approved the initiative. I heard of a company that turned recycled plastic caps and lids into benches. We decided that would cost a lot less than a brand new bench, and it would be a great way to get the community involved. Sammy made a comic explaining the buddy bench, and I posted on Facebook asking the community to help her save plastic caps and lids. It got shared a lot.
That's why we need your help collecting caps today.
I started hearing from people I didn't even know, saying they were bullied as a kid and would have loved to have a buddy bench when they were younger. Sammy's dream was to get 2 6-foot benches made, one for each of the school's playgrounds. We were hoping to have one within a year, but within 2 months' time, we had collected over 1,200 pounds of caps, enough for 3 benches. I'm so proud of Sammy. She led the whole process from initiating it to collecting caps, to sorting and then making the long trip to pick up the benches.
This is Sammy's buddy bench.
For a 9-year-old, I am so impressed with how she handled everything.
Oh, I'm crazy about this kid, and I'm crazy about her mom. Sammy Vance and her mom, Heidi, are with us now. What do you think, sweetheart, when you watch that video back? What's going through your mind?
I think that it's good that I did this project, so everybody has a friend.
Everybody's got a friend.
Mom, I can't imagine the pride, the joy you're feeling right now. When she first came to you with this idea, there are some moms who have said, go sit down, be quiet, you know, but you encouraged her. And now look, talk to me about this little jewel here.
She truly has a heart of gold. She loves people, all people, no matter what they look like, no matter what circumstances they're in. And she truly just came to me, I don't want anybody to be alone. My school needs this. I'd use it. I know other people would use it. Can we do it? So she made that appointment with the principal. He said, go ahead, and it took off. So proud of her.
So do you think there should be a buddy bench at every school in America, sweetie?
Yeah.
And how big is the bullying problem in schools, sweetie? We don't see it because we're old. But with kids in school, do you see it a lot?
Bullying's a big problem, and I really want it fixed.
Yeah.
So
it starts with one person doing something about it, right?